This story takes place 6 years ago. I was 16 at the time, so now you guys all know my age. It was right after my mom and dad told my younger sister and I that they're getting divorced. And my father, in all of his infinite wisdom, decides that the best way I'm going to deal with all of this is we're going to go on an adventure. Because that's how we dealt with things back then. Any new life things, any emotions, we just go on an adventure. We go do fun stuff together, we get back, and everything would be great. Because that's how that works. And, you know, I'm 16 at the time, super surly, not fun to be around. So I just had no interest in doing whatever he wanted to do. But, you know, I don't have a whole lot to say in the matter. So he kind of cooks up this idea, and we're going to kayak down a Kluna Lake. It's 7 miles. We're going to hike back to the glacier. It's another 6 miles. And then we're going to come back, and we're all going to do it in a day. So it's a 14-mile kayak and a 12-mile hike. So it's a pretty good day. And so we're going, and, you know, like I said, I have no desire to be on this trip, but here I am. And we're kayaking, and it's a nice day. It goes without a hitch. It's like a straight shot. Can't miss it. Hike back to the glacier. It's, you know, it's a glacier. It's pretty cool. Hike back, and so at this point where, you know, I'm pretty tired, and I'm just, all I'm thinking about is the final leg of this journey, this 7 mile kayak home, and then I'm done. So I take my pack, and I go, and I shove it into my kayak hatch, and I hear this pop and a hiss, and I see some red, and I have just enough time to think, that's kind of weird. And then, like, boom, it's like I'm punched in the face. And, you know, I'm on my back, and I'm kind of screaming, and it's like the worst burning sensation I've ever felt. And it's, you know, I can't see, and I can't breathe, and I can't talk. And my dad he has no idea what's going on, so he looks over and he goes, what happened? And I just choke out, bear spray. Because what had happened is careless me had just shoved my pack in the hatch, and the bear spray top that I keep with me, because I'm a responsible hiker, caught and just right in the face got me. So he kind of, like, being the quick thinker he is, just grabs me by the back and drags me over to the lake, and he's, you know, we're, like, kind of washing my face out and, you know, trying to clean all this stuff off. And as this is going on, I have this thought that, you know, when you, like, eat spicy food, you're not supposed to drink water because it's not going to help. You need milk, and you need bread. And we didn't have any milk with us, but what we did have was some tortillas that we were going to use for lunch. So in, like, a fit of desperation, I run over the kayaks, and I just grab the tortillas, and I just start scrubbing my face with them like it's a loofah, and I'm just going nuts and, like, you know, he's pretty worried at this point because that's not a normal thing to do under most circumstances. So I'm, like, scrubbing my face, and he's kind of, like, bucket brigading with water, and we kind of get it under control to where I can, like, see and talk and breathe again. But, you know, it still burns. It's not going to go away. It's, like, it's on there. And but, you know, we kind of examine our options. Like, well, you've used the last of the food. We kind of got to go home. So he, like, puts me back in the kayak and, you know, super supportive through the whole thing, make sure I'm not going to tip over. And we start kayaking home. It's just a quick 7 miles back. So at this point, I'm, like, pretty beat down. And I'm just kind of paddle after paddle. And I don't have a great sense of what's going on. I think, you know, like, it's probably about a half hour. Like, I'm just super thirsty after this whole ordeal. So I reach back and I grab my water bottle. And I take a big swig of water. And a now very familiar burning sensation runs down my throat. Because if you guys don't know how bear spray works, it goes off in a cloud. So everything in that cloud is going to be coated, including the water bottle that was right there. So I've now bear sprayed myself for the second time of the trip. And with as much grace as I can at the moment, I quickly paddle over shore. And luckily, there's a stream running down. And I just run and I dunk my head in the stream. And, you know, my dad, he still doesn't know what's going on, but he assumes it's bear spray related at this point. So he kind of paddles over, he's sitting next to me. He's like, you know, trying to joke and, you know, make things better. And every now and again, he'll pull my head out of the water, make sure I don't drown myself, and I'll go back down. And no concept of how long, like, you know, time is out the window, like, whatever. I'm just in a lot of pain. And he, you know, we're like about to start going again. And he says, you know, it's not that bad. I can see the shore from here. Which is not comforting if you guys have been to Kluna Lake, because you can see the shore the whole way. So, like, thanks, Dad. Yeah, let's go. So, you know, same thing. Like, I'm just head down, and, like, I honestly do not know how long it took to get back. So I'm just, like, paddle after paddle trying not to flip over. And we get to the end, and we're, like, 200 feet offshore. And I look up, and I see a bear on shore. And then I see another bear on shore, and then I'm seeing hundreds of bears on shore, and I go, Dad, that's how we can't go to shore. And he's like, oh, God, well, okay, why can't we go to the shore? I said, because there's hundreds of bears everywhere. And this starts like a 20-minute back and forth about how I'm pretty sure there's bears. And he's like, and he finally, you know, he talks me down. He says, Lucas, between the two of us, who do you think probably has better eyesight right now? And I have to concede, like, it's probably you. And he's like, okay, who do you think's in like a slightly better mental state right now? And again, I'm like, yeah, it's probably you. And he's like, you know, you're just gonna have to trust me on this one that I'm not leading you into a pack of bears. I'm like, that would be, you know, matching up with your past behavior, so I'll trust you on this one. So, you know, he leads me ashore, and as you guys can tell, there were no bears. And we load up, and we're driving home. It was a pretty quiet car ride back. And I just know that most of the car ride back, he's, like, thinking about how he's going to explain to his new ex-wife about how he definitely broke her son. And, like, all I'm thinking is, like, I would just kill for, like, a big glass of milk right now. Thank you.